16 different funds or programs that are better deserving of funding than the police. So basically, these are the different funds that I think we can focus on redistributing taxpayer dollars to after we defund the police. And I got, I guess, a lot of these 16 different programs from a list, and I'll read that to you right now. The list comes from 8 to Abolition. Again, the name of it is 8 to Abolition. Make sure you write that down. And not all of them are from their website, but a lot of them are. The rest are just from me Googling different places that cities spend their budgets. And then I just kind of chose. And before I start, I just wanted to read a quote that I really liked. And this quote I got from a Huffington Post article in the Black Voices section of the Huffington Post. And it's by someone named Saye Joseph. So just a sentence about Saye. She is a policy and advocacy manager at the Black Youth Project 100. Quote reads, "Over-policing does not actually keep communities safe. Police, in all forms, have been a way to keep property safe and to keep a subsection of society safe, but it hasn't kept all communities safe and healthy. We have to break the notion apart that police equals safety." So, in case you didn't get it, I'll read it again to you. "Over-policing does not actually keep communities safe. Police, in all forms, have been a way to keep property safe and to keep a subsection of society safe, but it hasn't kept all communities safe and healthy. We have to break the notion apart that police equals safety." And also during this video, I am going to be doing some tapping, and I have here something that I got. Ooh, let me grab it. So I got this at a protest on Saturday in DC. It was given to me by an artist. I didn't make this, and I actually forgot the name of the person who gave it to me, so if you're watching this, please comment your name so that I can give you credit, because there's no way that I could be talented enough to make something like this. So I'm going to be tapping on it. That's just my boyfriend. And I also wanted to read a few different statistics that I thought were really interesting and actually kind of terrifying. So the first is that in Los Angeles, 25% of the budget is spent on police. In Chicago, 40% of the budget is spent on police. Minneapolis, 35% of the budget is spent on police. And in Oakland, social service programs like youth programs, housing, and income support received less than 30 cents to every dollar given to the police in 2018. Which to me is truly just awful. Watching a GBA Smart video many years back, maybe it was a year back, and she talked a bit about the different types of tapping. So there's like the tapping with your, I guess, the tips of your fingers like this, but then you can also do your nails. And the poster obviously says, "Black Trans Lives Matter." Thank you. this list, and I got a lot of it from aid to abolition and some of it from just Googling. But this is obviously not an exhaustive list. If you can think of any other funds or programs that are deserving of funding, after we defund the police, then you can just comment those down in the comment section, and I'll be happy to add them to the description box. So I'm going to add my original 16 now, and any comment I see, I will add. Medicaid. Medicaid. Medicaid, 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 Medicaid. Number 5 is K-12 education. Higher education is number 6. Also, sorry you can hear motorcycles outside. You know, this apartment is not the most conducive to ASMR. Number 11. Number 11. Non-coercive drug and alcohol treatment programs. Non-coercive alcohol and drug treatment programs. place youth-based programs that promote learning, safety, and community care. Youth programs that promote learning, safety, and community care. Youth programs. So that's all 16. That I may have missed or that you would like to see added.